overzealous. They're trying to do another speedling counterattack while not actually having that much at the front. There is gravitonic.
Oh, now he's producing mutas though, so that's something.
So that is something to spend his gas on. But as I was saying, wouldn't like a fungal growth really freshen up this Protoss ball?
It would.
I mean, it would take 10 years off. It would take 10 health points off. You'll think you're so much younger. But he is getting mutas.
I think you're so much deader. I always feel sorry for the unit that's at like zero health and then gets put back into the front line.
Yeah, I don't understand why he's not vomiting creep here. I mean, just it's free. There's no disadvantage to it. Your overlords still do everything. This is good play. Always bring detection with so you can kill creep. That's kind. I mean, I know Terrans don't always work ravens into their play. I've been trying to lately because they're fun, but point defense drone as well as goodbye, Mr. Overlord. I do love that they just explode into blood. But instead of looking at that huge army, look at this. Creep actually affects the plant life. Isn't that cool? Now let's look at the big army.
Chasing another army. Oh, he's going straight for there. Oh, but he already has Colossus.
At this point, you're not trying to harass. At this point, you're trying to win. And mutaling isn't good for winning. It's good for harassing and keeping somebody scared. And this guy was well prepared. I think Roach Infestor Hydra would have worked great, because you would have had enough roaches to deal with all these Colossi, because he's not making out of more than one robo-facility. You would have had enough, and then had you gone Roach Hydra, about 50-50, the Hydras can deal with all these things. Then an Infestor to just soften everything up, it'd be great!
Can we look at the units lost tab? I have a feeling it won't show any good things. No.
Nope. Look at that. That is 4,000. Yep, 4,500 difference. But the Zerg is getting an expansion, and he's using his mutas to some good effect, especially preventing mining time. However, those mutas survived. That was close there. We are seeing more roaching, and let's look at the upgrades. It is 1-1 versus 2-1, but the supply difference is starting to show, and now it's only a 12 probe advantage. So then that is still. That is still
it's
about
a massive supply advantage.
Yeah, it's about 20 army supply, and also I would call Protoss's unit composition a bit better.
Yeah,
he has just the right amount of stalkers and immortals to deal with the roaches.
It's really hard to deal with that stalker ball.
And really, what you need to deal with the stalker ball is Ling Infestor, and then so if imagine if he had some Hydras in here and he had killed those Colossi that fast. Then he could have brought in all of his Hydralisks, and the Hydras would have taken this so stupidly quickly. But instead, he got stuck on Roachling, which I don't really like because you don't have a damage dealer. Roaches are tanks and are just sort of designed to be good all-around units. Lings are speedy, but they're not really like DPS units. They're high DPS, but they died too quickly to really be go-to. And now we're seeing—I mean, at this point, the Zerg is dead.
It's mopping up, yeah.
It's a tournament, so he's not going to quit too quickly, but, I mean, it's over. And we are seeing an interesting play. He's getting out of Warp Prism, and he actually researched Warp Prism speed, I noticed earlier. And yeah, now the Zerg, I mean, 31 Stalkers with Blink and 1-1. That is GG right there. An interesting game. He made some fundamentally good choices, but as we said, I think he just got a little overzealous.
Yeah, his attacking was... He wasn't attacking the right things at the right time.
And he also got stuck on Roaches and Zerglings when you do need some higher tech. Mm-hmm. Either Infestors as well as... Infestors as well as Hydralisks. The Mutas were a cool choice, but if he's going to do that, you're going to go Mutaling. You're going to go hardcore Mutaling. Instead, he tried to go Muta Roach, which... I mean, it takes finesse to pull off. This has been Admiral Newkirk, guest casting with Anacreon, and this was Game 3.